Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Revelation Infinite Journey on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Revelation Infinite Journey and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Revelation Infinite Journey. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the current URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to discover on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, simply because I provided a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up there on our own internet site of Usitility, at which we include an in-depth outline on the best way to obtain Revelation Infinite Journey on computer. We search lower a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Revelation Infinite Journey on our PC. As you can see here, we get a number of advantages of running the emulator. So we are ready to start downloading the Revelation Infinite Journey by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on that button. Of course, the download step takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We said yes. I minimized the internet browser to find the installation software better. The installation software is straightforward. It is made up of two options, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path does indeed. We basically click on it. And therefore we discover that we have now here the path in which the emulator is going to be placed. If we desire to vary this folder we have to click on the browse button, and therefore we choose another directory and install the emulator where we choose. I prefer to set it as it is. Then, I click on back. And therefore I pick install. Great, the install commences and it is going to move forward in the download of those megabytes which are shown on this screen. Once you download it, it may be a little bit more or less megabytes. The download speed will go at a higher speed or slower, based on your connection and according to the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they are working really fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator happens to be started on autopilot. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will fill up then when it gets to the finish, the emulator is started for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has been started, here for the first time. Before we continue on, as you will notice, it created two icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the one we're interested in. Anytime we need to operate Revelation Infinite Journey on our laptop or computer, we twice click this particular icon and consequently run the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi-Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we conduct the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and this is to enter the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is presented. In this case, we must log on. Right now, once we're on this page, we are required to begin doing this following step, which is obligatory. So that we click on Sign In. Presently it shows, Checking Info. It could occasionally get blocked in, Checking Info, and this isn't going to advance. In that case, you may attempt to connect to your account after a few hours, but it will surely usually be resolved. At this time we're going to type our email and password. The email has to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For example, you may use the very same email you are using at this time in your YouTube account. So that I will insert my information and I'll go back after I have accomplished it. Voila, info typed in. Below is Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We should approve them simply by pressing, I agree. Following that, it makes it possible to save to the Google Cloud. You can also let it check it's going to make a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can utilize this option if you desire. We just click on accept. The Google Play Store is started automatically and on autopilot. To install the app, we have got to browse the emulator desktop by clicking that icon marked green colored. At this point that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator for Android, we notice that we have now right here the install video game option. We simply click on that button. On this page we have got the game app. How about we simply click there on the install link that I'm just showing now in green. This action will commence the software installation. Presently it is going to install the Android game. It normally takes some time or it might well be very fast. It all relies on our connection to the web. It's actually finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by pressing the following option that I'm emphasizing in green, to be able to start Revelation Infinite Journey for the first time. I am presently on the emulator desktop, and then we are on the way to mouse click on this brand new Revelation Infinite Journey app icon which has been created. That game app is started for the very first time. Currently there we get it, I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the sound level of that emulator. It's right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we will switch on the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is actually the very first one. We simply click on this particular software icon that I'm showing in green color. Thus the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. In the case that we would like to launch the application using all the screen, we select this particular application icon. So we would probably without a doubt be experiencing the Android game in 100% screen mode. To get out of the 100% screen setting, push the F11 key. So we would undoubtedly just play in regular display screen setting. At this point, I am choosing to explain you the keys mapping that is definitely extremely exciting. That strategy we will certainly be capable to make use of the game more easily. The first task is to press this app icon. It's now time to get the recommended adjustments. I can let the standard configuration, but if you choose to change it, you can also do it without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is launched in the improper language, such as, in Japanese. And as a consequence to place it in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. So right here throughout various other controls, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can also go for the language we wish, Italian, Chinese, etc. After the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator would restart, as well as the game app, the next time we run it, will as well be in the opted for language. Right now, you can find another information that we have to take into account, and it's that we will get a message from Google Mail indicating that a brand new equipment has been connected to our Google account. It will definitely ask us if we are the individuals who have associated with that electronic device. Indeed, we shouldn't get worried, considering that the emulator is acting as an Google Android device. So you can find which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we go here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Let's browse here to the model selection. And there we learn that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for our video user demo. I believe you enjoyed it, especially that everyone found it helpful. In that case, give it a good like, subscribe to the channel, and I will be happy to answer all your remarks, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment field down below. You can even leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I do live streams occasionally, you get it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Just click on any of these training videos that happens to be appearing on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the next video game videos. Bye.